Let's begin with a look at the latest installment in Conrad Manila's Of Art and Wine series. What artworks are they going to showcase this time around? Let's find out.
Time and again, art has been utilized as a platform to spread awareness on different advocacies. Here at Conrad Manila, the Hotels of Art and Wine series continues with New Earth, New Life, New Hope, an exhibit meant to spark conversations about the importance of restoring and taking care of planet Earth.
The whole event is about new beginnings, it's about new earth, it's about protecting our environment and upcycling, using wastes to make things beautiful.
The exhibit showcases the meaningful and sustainable artworks of post-consumer artist Gilbert Angeles. His advocacy? To create awareness on the adverse effects of single-use plastics by creating an art style using shredded, discarded plastic sachets. He even uses old plywood, old paint, and even old paintings, which he paints over.
So, Eco Paint is when you mix the single-use shredded plastics into paint. So when you mix that paint, it becomes a vapor-like substance. It has an insulating component, and it's reinforcing the paint. So it's good for construction companies to use this as a material for their houses in the future.
24 of his artworks adorn the halls of Gallery C, contemporary pieces that come together in a symphony of colors, textures, and emotions. The shredded plastic blends seamlessly with the pieces, enhancing the form of the painting while highlighting Gilbert's commitment to the environment. It further shows how useless trash can be given a new life and turned into priceless works of art. The collection features paintings inspired by celestial bodies, such as the explosive reds and yellows of the star Betelgeuse or the greens of Nebula, scenes from Mother Nature like Four Seasons, and something more contemplative in Iridescence, Providence, Metal Bane, and Intertwined.
So the thing is, to be sustainable, I am connected in a construction company who's shredding this material. Because if I'm going to shred this, it will take me a year to have one stock of it. That's the first process, to collect all those materials and give it to a shredding facility, and then take out those shredded materials and think of how you will use this as a communicator to everyone. So the thing is, the material itself is already a message. And by creating that message, it becomes a spirit. And everyone who look at that spirit comes alive. And it becomes a communication towards the artist who does the artwork, and the artwork to the audience.
During the launch of the exhibit at the Conrad Manila, Gilbert did an on-site and online masterclass on how he incorporates shredded plastic in his artworks. Gilbert hopes that through the green arts movement, more people can use this art medium to raise consciousness on the harmful effects of post-consumer waste. He is also optimistic that creative minds will collaborate and think of new ways to evolve the use of this medium in order to further raise awareness.
I like my audience to interpret or connect with the artwork. I want them to see the energy, see the vibration that I am making. So if they are going to be touched by those paintings and somehow influence them and be reminded that don't throw away your waste. Be mindful of your trash because we are the third polluter of the world's ocean.
exhibit comes right before the celebration of April's Earth Month and at a time when people are in dire need of inspiration. Looking at the bigger picture, in this case, plastic pollution and sachet dependency can encourage people to work towards a common goal despite the tragedies happening around us. As Gilbert says, while a small painting can't save all the trash in the world, this small way can raise awareness and start conversations on post-consumer waste.
Next, we head to ArtCube to check out the three exhibits that are currently housed within that space. Watch this.
Different galleries offers unique art experiences. Its interiors, including the placement of lights, walls, and even windows, play a vital role in creating the mood for an art exhibit.
Originality, and of course, you can't miss creativity and skill, but lately we've been looking for a lot of artists with wit and very good visual narratives.
ArtCube houses 2 to 3 exhibits every month. As a safety protocol, they can only accommodate a maximum of 15 people. This March, it will showcase 3 artists whose works narrate stories from the past in an attempt to immortalize them in the present.
The artists are very, of course, very diverse, but I'm getting a lot of walk-ins here that they're saying it feels very nostalgic, the shows in the gallery now, as if it was curated to have them do a show all together and have their theme like sentimental.
One of the exhibits was Jonathan Hoven's Square Meters. Through the use of repurposed architectural blueprints as grounds for his paintings, Hoven tells the story of his past desire to own a home, despite and because of the conditions that he faced while living in the slums of Tondo, Manila. Anchored on heavy truths on class inequality and poverty, Hoven's paintings exude grit, angst, and surprisingly warmth. His use of color and delicate brushstrokes led the viewers into an interesting art exploration. At the center of the space lies a captivating installation that is made of soil, wood, stones, and cement. It's amazing how these construction materials that we normally see everywhere, when arranged together, evokes a feeling that one might carry even after leaving the gallery. Steps away from the exhibit hang multiple black and white paintings that comprise Azer Pascoguing's solo exhibit Noon. Through a monochromatic color palette, Azer features portraits of artists, equipment, and legends from the past. Azer's attention to detail and undeniable skill in working with canvas shed new light on the outdated glory of old objects and almost forgotten legends. The last exhibit is Nick Navarro's eerie exploration on the idea of superstitions. Nick set up an altar-like installation comprised of items that are used to counter evil spirits in the traditional Filipino culture. But the most haunting aspect of the exhibit are his actual surreal and symbolic contemplations behind every artwork. In Sa Ating Pagkabusog Ay Di Na Muli Tayo Makukontento, the artist confronts the old superstition that one's soul departs from the body should one happen to fall asleep while hungry. Through his highly charged depiction of a room and a white silhouette of a man on the wall, he conveys how one's hunger for limitless knowledge can consume the soul. He also features today's current realities through his painting. With a perfect blend of warm and neutral colors, he painted the narrative of today's pandemic as if it were an old, ancient photograph. For the staff of ArtCube, the beauty of the space lies in the walls that have borne witness to the stories delivered by artists from across the country. And the Art Cube continues to provide space for artists who yearn to tell their stories through the gallery's walls.